Right, so in this video, I'll teach you how we can build browser scraping agent. We're gonna use this agent to scrape dentists' leads from Yellow Pages. Yellow Pages website is an online business directory that helps you find information about businesses, services, and professionals with respect to your location. In this video, we're gonna use Crawl4AI. Crawl4AI is the first trending GitHub repository. It is end-to-end framework that helps you to scrape whatever you need to scrape from your browser. And they have very well-organized documentation that helps you implement your project so smoothly. First thing first, go to the repository that I will provide the link of it in the description below. Clone the repository and install all the needed dependencies by installing the requirements.txt. And you have to have API key from Gemini or OpenAI or Grok. And you can get your Gemini API key for free from Google AI Studio. Even Grok provides free API. So pick anyone from the three and you are ready to start. Now the idea behind Crawl4AI is quite simple. You have a web page that you want to scrape, and from this web page you can extract the markdown language, which is HTML or CSS, wherever, as you know. And by your instruction or your prompt, you can filter which part of the landmark you want to extract, or what is the target part that you want to extract and organize. And with the help of a structure schema that helps you to structure the raw data or the markup language from the web page into structure format, we pass that to the LLM to be able to structure the data in a way that you can use it. For example, CSV format or JSON. So this is simply the idea of Crawl4AI. Now let's jump into the implementation. First, we have the code that defines the data model using Bidentic AI. We have business data class, and this class is used to validate the data structure. As we can see, we want to structure the data in the following format. We have the name, address, phone number, website, and description. And each field has the description, and the field is just as metadata for one entity, which is name or address or whatever. So the purpose of this class is just to have consistent format before pre-processing the data. And then we have the main code file, which is the scraper that we can use for data scraping. First, we are importing JSON to have kind of formatting the data in JSON format, and Bidentic AI to use base model that help us to organize the data. And we have a sync web crawler that we're gonna use for web page fetching. This is the core model that we're gonna use. And browser configuration, which is defines how browser behave, something like if we want to visualize the process of extracting the data, we can define this in the browser configuration. And the cache mode, just for controlling the caching during the process. And crawler run config to adjust the settings per request, and so on. And this method right there is for configuring the browser. We are using Chromium, and Chromium basically is the engine behind Chrome, Google Chrome. And the headless equal true, which means that we don't need to visualize the process of extracting the data. And verbose equal true, which means that we want to print the logs for something like debugging to be able to visualize or to observe the process of extracting the data. And we have LLM strategy, which is defines how the LLM can extract the data. And we have get LLM strategy that defines how the LLM gonna extract the structured data from the raw or from the markup language. And the schema gonna helps the LLM to structure the data in the proper way. The input format is markdown language, which is HTML or any web language, and verbose equal true to just visualize the logging. And we have method to check if there are no results. It uses web crawler, which is a sync web crawler that we have assigned above. And this is the URL of the target page and session ID. A session ID simply is unique identifier for crawling session. And this method simply returns boolean. So if there are results, it's gonna be false. And if there are no results is going to be true. And we have a method called fetch and process page. And this method simply takes the following parameters. The first one is the crawler, which is, as I mentioned, a sync web crawler, and the page number, because we can iterate through large number of pages or wherever you need to iterate, but it more than one page. And we have the CSS selector, which is points to specific CSS selector to be able to extract only the data that we care about. And the session ID, which is the unique identifier for the current or the current working session. And this line there runs the asynchronous web crawler to fetch the web page. And it takes the following parameters, which is the URL and crawler run config that we have defined with all the following parameters. And we are checking if there are no results to return false or nothing. And if there are results, we can store this in JSON format in variable called extracted data. And we print the extracted data in the terminal. And after extracting the data from the web page, we're gonna iterate through to remove any replicated instance, handling some errors, and so on. We're gonna use this scraper to scrape data from YOLO pages. And YOLO pages is simply an business network, and we have the LM instruction or the user prompt, which is gonna filter the markdown language from the browser. So not all the HTML content we gonna need. We need to trim or get a specific part from. So the user or the LM instruction gonna define this. And the output format is business data as we defined in business.by. This is the clause that has the five entities or the five properties. On the right there, we have page number, which we're gonna start from page number one, and the records to track the records, and scene name, which is set, so it avoids any duplication, because sets assembly can't has two similar values. So it's just for avoid replication. And we're gonna iterate over the pages until there are no more pages to be extracted. But in our logic, we're gonna limit the number of pages to be extracted. And this is the configuration file, which defines the LLM model. In this case, I'm using Gemini 2.0 Flash, which is free and accessible. You can get your API key simply by going to AI Studio and assigning the API token from .env. And this is the base URL. We can go and visit this. So before visiting the URL, simply you are copying the URL from the page that you want to extract or from the page that you want to scrape. And you only replace the index or page number with this variable to be able to iterate through the page. So I'll show you now how you can do this. So simply this was the URL in the configuration file, but let me just remove the page number and put any number, something like one, and that's it. This is the first page that we want to extract or scrape, and we can play with this index. So now we are in page one, we can delete one and put three, and we are in page three. So this logic can be used for pretty much any website, for example, Amazon. So in this case, I'm searching on laptop Lenovo, and I'm searching in page number two, as we can see, page equal two. So if you want to scrape this website, you can take the URL and replace the URL in this place right there, and just replace the index with page number to be able to iterate through the pages. And this is the CSS selector that we're going to use to differentiate between the important data and the metadata that we don't need to extract or to prompt it to the LLM. And the maximum number of pages is three. As I mentioned, it is limited to avoid any long sessions. So let's run our project. But before, let me assign false value to headless to allow us to visualize logs or the process of extraction. And let me save this file and run main.py. So it opens the YOLO pages and the process of scraping is working right there. And these are the data printed in JSON format as we defined in scraper.py. And thanks to Verbis, we can see the execution logs. And here we go, the data extracted, as we can see. And I've got the CSV file. Let me open it from Excel to be able to see it. So we have businessdata.csv. We can open it. We can open it and check the data. We have name, address, phone number, website, and description. And that's it for today. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video.